Greetings. There once was a short man who went into the jungle. He was ashamed by being short compared to his neighbors. And coming upon a tribe of pygmies, he thought to himself, "How may I convince these pygmies to side with me and to follow me as their leader? They seemed fierce and angry already, but how can I get them to fight loyally for me?" And he came upon a brilliant scheme. He would convince them they were not pygmies. He would convince them they were not small. And so the man began scheming, wondering how he could convince the pygmies that they were taller than their actual stature. He decided to trick them into thinking they were very tall. He schemed a plan that could not fail. Now, how do you suppose his scheme worked? If you were him, how would you go about deceiving them to think they were very tall? If you found a tribe of pygmies in the jungle, and you were roughly their height, 4 feet tall, how would you convince them that, even though they were in fact very short compared to the rest of mankind, that they were very tall? How would you trick them into thinking they were the tall ones? Any ideas? You would only need to do what this man did. You would only need to tell them you are tall, and then prevent them from ever hearing the truth. Just repeat in their ears, "You are so very tall," and all the better if you can convince them to change the name of their tribe to the Tall Ones. If you can get them to call themselves Tall Ones, you've gone a long way to selling the deception and making it unquestionable. Every time they refer to themselves, they will reinforce they are the Tall Ones. Then get them to demand that others call them the Tall Ones, even when the others are clearly taller than the pygmies. Make sure you always call the pygmies the Tall Ones. You see, it does not matter that, in fact, they are not tall. When the Tall Ones meet together, they all call each other Tall Ones. Every time they refer to themselves, they will reinforce they are the Tall Ones. When they meet others, they introduce themselves saying, "I am a Tall One." And while this is generally met with snickering and suppressed laughter, very few dare laugh at the pygmies for fear of hurting their feelings. Other men have learned that the pygmies are overly sensitive, dysfunctional even. And so other men, not of the Tall Ones, play along and do not challenge their self-delusion. And this is how the clever man convinced the pygmies that they were the Tall Ones. But even while the pygmies were not tall, to this very day, many generations after the man died, they still claim they are the Tall Ones. They still introduce themselves as the Tall Ones. And to this day, even though they are the shortest people on the planet, they live in their delusion that they are the Tall Ones. The amazing thing of this parable is that it is a true story. A man did find a group of people in a wilderness, and that man did call them by a certain name. And the man convinced them to change their name and accept his description. And though the people never did fit the name, they believed they did. And they fought for the man, and died for the man. All the while they were not what the man called them. Yet they demanded that others call them by the name the man had given them. And to this very day, people who do not fit the word they were given introduce themselves with it. They demand others call them by it. They get mad if you do not use the name the man gave them. Who was the man? I think you know. What was the name? Muslim. And now you know the parable of the Pygmies. People convinced to receive a label that does not apply by a man whose intent was to trick and to use them. Because just as the man could never make the Pygmies taller, Muhammad could never lead his followers to a God he did not know. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.